For making pudina sevi, we will take half cup of fresh pudina, mint leaves to a mixer grinder, and in this we will also add 2 green chilies, 1 inch of ginger peas and 8 to 10 garlic cloves. Also to this we will add half a teaspoon of salt and then grind it into a fine paste. Moving on, we have to take potatoes. These are 3 boiled potatoes. We will not mash them but grate them with a grater so that there are no lumps or solid pieces in our aloo mash. So now we are ready with our grated aloo. We have taken here 2 cups of grated aloo. To this we will add 2 + 1/4 cup of besan gram flour. To this we will also add salt as per taste or 1 teaspoon, half a teaspoon of baking powder, a pinch of asafoetida powder, hing powder, a teaspoon of chaat masala, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric haldi. Now add a tablespoon of oil to get a crispy sieve. Now add the made pudina paste. Combine everything together to get a soft sticky dough. If the dough seems too sticky, you can apply a little bit of oil over your palms. Next, we require a chakli maker. Here we will divide the dough into cylindrical portions. Taking this perforated plate, we will make sieve and grease your chakli maker before adding the dough. If you don't have a chakli maker, you can even use a piping bag and make your pudina sieve in any other shape as you like. Drop into a medium hot oil and don't add too much of sieve into the oil at once. If you add too much of sieve at once, it will crumble up, get messy and you won't get the nice shape of your sieves. Fry over a medium heat and when you see they are a little bit firm or fried on one side, you can give it a light flip and fry it on the other side. And yes, as you know, we need to fry them till golden brown and crisp. And then you can strain out your pudina sieve over a paper towel, but don't keep over the towel for too long, otherwise it might get soggy and soft because of oil moisture. Transfer it into a bowl and then we will sprinkle some dry mint and chaat masala over it, taking 1/4 teaspoon of each. Our perfect crunchy pudina sieve is ready. You can store them into an airtight container for about a month. If you like the recipe, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share, comment, subscribe, hitting the bell icon till we meet again with another interesting recipe. Bye-bye.